Hi, and welcome to our how-to video series. Today I'm going to show you how to change a top strut mount. The top strut mount is possibly one of the most important parts of a vehicle's steering and suspension. As the name suggests, it attaches the top of the suspension strut to the vehicle chassis, cushioning the impact between the two for a smooth and quiet ride. Many front strut mounts also contain a bearing, which acts as a steering pivot. So as you turn the wheels from side to side, the strut pivots on the top strut mount, controlling the angle and the alignment of the wheels. Although they're designed to last, the weight of the vehicle coupled with the constant movement can cause significant wear, impacting both driver comfort and the handling of the vehicle. Therefore, it is important to check for any signs of damage and replace when necessary. So let's show you how to do that. Today, we're going to use a Volkswagen Golf, but be aware that the process can vary from one vehicle to another, so please check your vehicle handbook for any specifics. Okay, to start, remove any plastic wheel covers from the vehicle. Then, before raising the vehicle, loosen the wheel nuts. If you have an air impact gun, you can skip this step, but be sure not to use it on any locking wheel nuts. Now we can raise the vehicle. And now we can remove the wheel nuts. Remember to put them somewhere safe so not to lose them. Once the wheel's off, we can check to see what needs to be moved out of the way. In this case, we need to move the brake line bracket and also move the drop link. We need a 19mm spanner and we're going to loosen the nut from the drop link. Now we've removed the nut, we can remove the drop link like so. Next, we focus on the lower clamp bolt that attaches the strut to the knuckle. Next, we need to separate this strut from the hub. And generally, there can be some force required when removing this hub from the strut. And just like that, the strut should come away from the hub, allowing us to now remove the top bolts. Okay, so we've lowered the car so we can now gain access to the strut top mount through here. To get into the bolts, we need to just pull this rubber away here. Once we lift this trim up, we'll be able to access the bolts using a ratchet with a 13mm socket. However, we're not going to remove this bolt right here, as that will release the spring, which is not what we want to do. So whilst holding the strut like so, once all three bolts are removed, ensure they're kept safe because they will need to be reused later as well. Okay, so as you can see here, the spring is under tension, meaning it has significant energy stored up, which could cause serious injury if released. To prevent this, you'll need to securely and safely clamp the spring to hold the tension and create enough play so that you can remove the strut mount. This will allow us to undo the top mount using a deep spanner and an Allen key. We can then undo the top nut. And securing the strut at this side, carefully remove the old top mount. So now we can replace with the new top mount. With some manufacturers, you may need to align the bearing with the top mount. And also when fitting to the strut, you may also need to align the top mount with the spring. On this one, we don't, so we can go ahead and put it on the top and put the nut straight back on. When tightening the top mount, we should always ensure that the strut remains in the correct position with the spring at the bottom or top if it's got lugs at the top. So now the top mount's back on tight, we can begin to decompress the spring. One final check to do before we fit back to the vehicle is if there is a boot protector to ensure that it is placed back into the top mount as it was originally found. We can now remove the strut from the compressor and it can be refitted back onto the vehicle. When doing so, try to always keep note of which way the strut faced when it came off. Some manufacturers can have brackets on that need to go back into a specific direction. So whilst holding the strut in place, we can now screw the bolts back in loosely. That will allow you to free up your other hand from holding the strut. Then we can resume tightening the bolts using the socket and the ratchet that we used earlier. Okay, now we have the top mount tight and the strut back in place, I can go ahead and refit the drop link that we removed earlier, as well as refit the bolt for the lower clamp. Top tip, guys, when you're placing the hub back onto the strut, sometimes using a jack can help with the fight against gravity. In doing so, also make sure you check that your key is aligned at the back of the hub so that you have no fouling. Once the hub's back in place, we can go ahead and refit the bolt, ensuring the nut is back on the end and the drop link can go back into its original place. So, now everything's tight again, I can go ahead and put the wheel back on. And now we have the car back on the ground, we can torque the top mount bolts and the strut tower. Once that's done, we can put the wheel cover back onto the vehicle. Finally, it's recommended to have the vehicle's wheel alignment checked and also perform a small test drive to ensure the steering wheel is straight. And remember, it's best practice to fit strut top mounts in pairs, both the right side and the left. Doing this will ensure performance is evenly matched across the axle. Also, because the strut top mounts are essentially a low-cost part in what can be a very labour-intensive process, as we've seen today, it's often recommended to replace these whenever changing the struts and or the springs. So that's how to change a strut top mount. For more best practice advice, remember to check Delphi Technologies' YouTube channel.